my training is in an area called computational linguistics. It's a subfield of artificial intelligence, and that provided a foundation in processes of human communication and how computational media can play a role. First, you become a computer scientist, and then you break a lot of that training and open your eyes to the world and see that not everything is a science problem and not every solution is derived from the scientific method. And then you realize that, you know, you really need interdisciplinary approaches to things. One of my research projects is concerned with helping those who have been negatively affected in terms of their ability to speak, for instance, following stroke or in the face of neurodegenerative disease like Parkinson's disease. It's known in general that for motor rehabilitation, visual feedback is very important. So in terms of rehabilitating speech, visual feedback in the form of data that concerns one's motor speech or acoustical properties of speech is known to be important, and this is the area that we're hoping to innovate and to devise new visualization techniques. Rehabilitation technology is about helping those recover or regain skills that were lost through some kind of, often the case, medical crisis. The idea to use visual feedback for speech rehabilitation is not a new one. In fact, it goes back several decades. However, the previous work has really looked at creating anatomically based models and to show to the individual receiving rehabilitation how their vocal tract is actually operating. But we know that that kind of visualization is not particularly useful, or at least individuals are not able to use those visualizations to actually support motor learning. So our idea is to derive the data and to reformulate it into a form that is perhaps more effective. So for instance, we use metaphors, we use scenes of animals, dragons, flowers, whatever. There's a lot of room for design in this space, but we're not using anatomical models. Rather, we're using abstractions, but packaging the data, particularly motor speech data, into these new, possibly more intuitive forms for feedback. We have a prototype where we've created a scene of a dragon breathing fire, and the client who's receiving rehabilitation services in effect controls the dragon. We place targets in the scene that represent things that the dragon needs to burn down, but the dragon's fiery breath is controlled by their motor speech production. So by positioning the targets for destruction, for fiery doom, we in effect elicit a kind of motor production that's going to help them with their motor rehabilitation. There's a lot of aspects involved in motor rehabilitation. For sure, there's supporting the motor learning, so you have to provide clinically relevant targets, but also engagement and enticement to continue over weeks and weeks of what can be honestly pretty boring exercises, repetitive, boring motor speech exercises. So we're obviously looking at the power of the digital media to entice and to engage users in courses of rehabilitation that sometimes can last weeks and weeks. Some key collaborators are Dr. Yana Yunusova and Dr. Petros Feloutsos. Dr. Yana Yunusova is a professor at the University of Toronto. She is a speech-language pathologist, and she has research expertise in, among other things, motor speech production and the impact of neurologic disease on motor speech production. Dr. Petros Feloutsos is a full professor in the Department of Electrical Engineering and Computer Science. He's a research colleague, and his area of expertise is in computer graphics and computer animation. For the VTV research project, the challenge and the benefit arise from the same source, which is really the interdisciplinary nature of the collaboration. So in this project, we bring together those with expertise in human-centered design, speech-language pathology, speech science, computer graphics, computer animation, motion control, data analysis, and it can be a challenge to bridge across disciplinary divides, but there's also a great benefit from bringing people with such disparate expertise together on a common goal and a common project.